photographs and memories. Christmas cards you sent to me, all that I have are these to remember you. Memories that come at night, take me to another time, back to a happier day when I called you mine. But we sure had a good time when we started way back when. Morning walks and bedroom talks are how I loved you then. Summer skies and lullabies, nights we couldn't say goodbye. And of all of the things that we knew, not a dream survived. Photographs and memories, all the love you gave to me, somehow it just can't be true. It's all I've left of you. But we sure had a good time when we started way back when. Morning walks and bedroom talks are how I loved you then.
Its hustlers, Bowery got its bumps. 42nd Street got Big Jim Walker, he pool shooting son of a gun. Yeah, he big and dumb as a man can come, but he's stronger than a country horse. And when the bad folks all get together at night, you know they all call Big Jim boss, just because. You see, you don't tug on Superman's cape, you don't spit into the wind, you don't pull old Lone Ranger, and you don't mess around with Jim. Well, out of South Alabama come a country boy. He said, I'm looking for a man named Jim. I am a fool shooting boy, my name is Willie McCoy, but down at home they call me Slim. Yeah, I'm looking for the king of 42nd Street. He drive on a drop-top Cadillac. Last week he took all my money, and it may sound funny, but I come to get my money back. Everybody say, Jack, don't you know that you don't tug on Superman's cape, you don't spit into the wind, you don't pull the mask off the old Lone Ranger, and you don't mess around with Jim. Well, a hush fell over the pool room as Jimmy come bopping in an awful street. When the cutting was done, the only part that wasn't bloody was the soles of the big man's feet. Yeah, he was cutting about 100 places, and he was shot in a couple more. And you better believe I sung a different kind of story when the Big Jim hit the floor. With a sing, you don't tug on Superman's cape, you don't spit into the wind, you don't pull the mask off old Lone Ranger, and you don't mess around with Slim. Big Jim got his hat. Find out where that is not hustling people strange to you. Even if you do got a two-piece custom-made pool cue. You don't tug on Superman's cape. You don't spit into the wind. You don't pull the mask off the old Lone Ranger, and you don't mess around with Slim.
could you help me place this call? See, the number on the matchbook is old and faded. She's living in L.A. with my best old ex-friend Ray. Gosh, she said she knew well and sometimes hated. Isn't that the way they say it goes? But let's forget all that and give me the number if you can't find it, so I can call just to tell them I'm fine and to show. Overcome the blow, learn to take it well. Only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels. Could you help me place this call? 'Cause I can't read the number that you just gave me. There's something in my eyes, you know it happens every time. Think about the love that I thought would save me. Isn't that the way they say it goes? Well, let's forget all that and give me the number if you can't find it, so I can call just to tell them I'm fine and to show. Overcome the blow, learn to take it well. I only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels. No, 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 no. That's not the way it feels. Operator, oh, let's forget about this call. There's no one there I really wanted to talk to. So thank you for your time. Oh, you've been so much more than kind. You can keep the dime. They say it goes. Well, let's forget all that and give me the number if you can't find it, so I can call just to tell them I'm fine and to show. Overcome the blow, learn to take it well. I only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels.
Up until last year, most of my musical experience was centered around bar rooms, country and western bars, kind of places you see in movies like Easy Rider, with three or four chrome-plated pickup trucks sitting out front, a rifle rack in the back window. And you get up on a stage to play and they have you surrounded by chicken wire so that you don't get injured by beer bottles and flying pitchers as all this stuff is going on. I met a lot of characters in these places, and a lot of them I ended up putting into songs. This is a song about a woman who I met one night. I was sitting down playing, and she was sitting about 10 feet away from me, and every time I watched her clap, I could see the fat under her arm jiggling back and forth like that. It was a beautiful sight. I knew that I had to write a tune about her. So I started talking to her. It turned out that she came from Texas, and she used to be in a roller derby. So I knew right then that anybody that heavy and that small, I had to have a tune written about her. We don't usually do it at home because her husband's a state trooper, and he could really, really mess up a nice day, I think, if he got upset. So we're going to do it here, though. It's called I Fell in Love with the Roller Derby Queen. I'm going to tell you a story that you won't believe, but I fell in love last Friday evening with the girl I saw on the barroom TV screen. Well, I I was just getting ready to get my hat when she caught my eye, and I put it back, and I ordered myself a couple of more shots and beers. The night that I fell in love with a roller derby queen, round and round, all round and round, the meanest hunk of woman that anybody ever seen. Down in the arena she was 5'6", but 215, a bleach blonde bomber with a streak of mean. She knew how to knuckle and she knew how to scuffle and fight. Program said that she was built like a refrigerator with a head. Her fans called her Tuffy, but all her buddies called her Spike. The night that I fell in love with a roller derby queen, round and round, all round and round, the meanest hunk of woman that anybody ever seen. Down in the arena, help it but to fall in love with this heavy duty woman I've been speaking of. Things were kind of bad until the day she skated into my life. Well, she might be nasty, she might be fat, but I never met a person who could doubt her that. She's my bleach blonde bomber, my heavy-handed Hackensack mama. The night that I fell in love with a roller derby queen, around and round, all round and round, the meanest hunk of woman that anybody ever seen. Down in the arena,
running away from something we both know. We've long run out of things to say, and I think I better go. So don't be getting excited when you hear that slam on door, 'cause there'll be one less set of footsteps on your floor in the morning. And we've been hiding from something that should have never gone this far, but after all, it's what we've done that makes us what we are. And you've been talking in silence, well, if I silence you adore, well, every one less set of footsteps on your floor in the morning. Well, every one less set of footsteps on your floor, one less voice of talking, and one less pair of jeans upon your door, one less man to walk in. But tomorrow's a dream away, and today has turned to dust. Your silver tongue has turned to clay, and your golden rule to rust. If that's the way that you want it, well, that's the way I want it more, 'cause there'll be one less set of footsteps on your floor in the morning. One less set of footsteps on your floor, one less voice of talking, and one less pair of jeans upon your door, one less man to walk in. But tomorrow's a dream away, and today has turned to dust. Your silver tongue has turned to clay, and your golden rule to rust. If that's the way that you want it, well, that's the way I want it more, 'cause there'll be one less set of footsteps on your floor in the morning. Yeah, there'll be one less set of footsteps on your floor in the morning.
Thank you. feeling all alone. When your good time friends have all got up and gone, don't come knocking around my door, because I've heard your lines before. There ain't gonna be a next time this time, 'cause woman's starting right now. I'm gonna forget your name and your pretty face, girl, and write you off as a bad mistake. You know that some women, they are lovers, some just got no sense. But a woman like you ought to be ashamed of the things that you do to men. If you get to feeling all alone, when you find that you can't make it on your own, don't come knocking around my door. You see, I've seen your act before. There ain't gonna be a next time this time, 'cause woman's starting right now. I'm gonna forget your name and your pretty face, girl, and write you off as a bad mistake. You know that some women, they are lovers, and some just got no sense. But a woman like you ought to be ashamed of the things that you do to men. If you get the feeling you were wrong, don't go wasting your good money in the phone, 'cause I can hang up as fast as you can call. That ain't all, 'cause there ain't gonna be a next time this time, 'cause woman's starting right now. I'm gonna forget your name and your pretty face, girl, write you off as a complete disgrace. You know that some women, they are liars, and some just got no sense. But a woman like you ought to be ashamed of the things that you do to men. Yeah, a woman like you ought to be ashamed of the things that you do to men.
Thank you. Thank you very much. You know, I haven't been doing so much music as I have been a lot of other things. I've been driving a tractor trailer and a gravel truck, spending a lot of time sitting behind the wheel, like that, like the lady in the roller derby song. But I spend a lot of time in truck stops, drinking a lot of coffee and just watching what goes down. And it's funny because most of the runs I would make wouldn't be, you know, more than a day, so I was always back home. But some of these truck stops, you see guys pulling in that have been driving nonstop for maybe 2 or 3 days. Now that's really something to see. You see them walking in like with that kind of expression on their face. You know they've been up too long. They have a term that they call these things they get into called West Coast turnarounds, which are like directional aids, I suppose. You take one in New York and you drive out to California and turn around and drive right back all the time. They cut off a broomstick about that long and wedge it down on the throttle pedal and then against the seat, so you have an extra foot to move around and dance with or do whatever you want. It's a lot of fun. I think the truck drivers are really a good bunch of people. I know all the guys that I hang around with back home are truck drivers and guys I've worked with over the past few years. It's, you know, there's a story about truckers. One of them had gotten 1,000,000 miles in cab truck. Now that's really a lot of driving. And a radio station was interviewing him. And they said, you know, 1,000 hours, you know, every couple weeks. I mean, people are logging time on a highway in these trucks. It's really amazing. And you have like 1,000,000 miles in. That's about 15 or 20 years worth of driving. He says, yeah. He says, I've seen just about everything happen, too. He said, I've had bad weather. He says, I've slipped and slid off the highway. I've jackknifed, blown out back tires and front tires, lost my brakes. The radio station guy said, you know, he said, let me just set up a situation so the people out there will know what kind of nerves and quick reflexes you guys all have. He said, sure. He said, suppose you're driving from Los Angeles into New York City and you come over top peak of the Rockies. And it's about 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning. You see the sign, it says 3-mile downhill run. no runaway truck lane, truckers use low-low gear. And like you kick it down into low-low gear, your partner's sleeping next to you. And just as you hit the crest and you go down about a half a mile, you find out that you don't have any brakes. The trucker goes, mm-hmm. He says, well, and then you look down around the first curve and you see a little Volkswagen up on a jack, getting a back tire changed. The trucker looked up and he said, mm-hmm. And then, he says, coming up the other lane, you see a fuel oil truck in low-low gear. What do you think you'd do? The trucker sat there and looked for a little while. He said, so I think I'd wake my partner up. Wow, he says, but all these things happening, you'd wake your partner up, right? He says, yep. He says, why would you do that? He says, well, he hasn't been driving long, and I know he ain't never seen a wreck like this before. And that's the story of Speedball Tucker. One, two, three, four.
I drive a broke-down rig on made-pop tires, 40 foot of overload. A lot of people say that I'm crazy because I don't know how to take it slow. I got a broomstick on the throttle to keep her opened up and held right down. Non-stop back to Dallas, popping them West Coast turnarounds. And they call me Speedball, Speedball Tucker, terror of the highway. And all them other truckers will tell you that the boy is mad to be driving in a rig like that. You know the rain may blow, the snow may snow, and the turnpikes they may freeze. But they don't bother old Speedball, he going any dang way he please. He got his broomstick on the throttle to keep his throttle foot a dancing round. With a cup full of cold black coffee and a pocket full of West Coast turnarounds. And they call him Speedball, Speedball Tucker, terror of the highway. And all them other truckers will tell you that the boy is mad to be driving in a rig like that. One day I looked into my rearview mirror, and coming up from behind, there was a Georgia State policeman and a $100 fine. Well, he looked me in the eyes, he was writing me up. He said, driver, you been flying, 'cause 95 is the route you were on. It was not the speed limit sign. And they call me Speedball, Speedball Tucker, terror of the highway. And all them other truckers will tell you that the boy is mad to be driving in a wreck like that. Yeah, they call me Speedball, Speedball Tucker, terror of the highway. And all them other truckers will tell you that the boy is mad to be driving in a rig like that.
Just a matter of time, but now I've come to my decision, and it's one of the painful kind. 'Cause now it seems that you wanted a martyr, just a regular guy wouldn't do. And baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you. You really got to hand it to you, girl, you really tried. But for every time that we spent laughing, there were two times that I cried. And you were trying to make me your martyr, and that's the one thing I just couldn't do. And baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you. These tables are meant for turning, are bound to change. Bridges are meant for burning, and the people and memories, they join all the same. So I hope that you can find another who can take what I could not. have to be a super guy, or maybe a super god. 'Cause I never was much of a martyr before, and I ain't about to start nothing new. Baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you. These tables are meant for turning, and people are bound to change. And bridges are meant for burning when the people and memories they join on the same. So I hope that you can find another who can take what I could not. Have to be a super guy, or maybe a super god. 'Cause I never was much of a martyr before, and I ain't about to start nothing new. Baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you.
That's a really new tune called Lover's Cross. And this is another new one. It's kind of got that funky street feel. People, you know, sometimes get a case of mistaken identity about what they should be doing. And this is a story about a guy that thinks he should be ruling the universe somewhere, but he's really working at a car wash. The title's really a long one. It's called I Goddamn Steadily Depressing, Low Down Mind Messing, Working at the Car Wash Blues.
Doesn't got out from the county prison, doing 90 days for non-support. Tried to find me an executive position, but no matter how smooth I talk, he wouldn't listen to the fact that I was a genius. The man says we got all that we can use. Now I got them steadily depressing, low down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. Well, I shouldn't be sitting in an air-conditioned office in a swivel chair, talking some trash to the secretary, saying, hey now, mama, come on over here. But instead, I'm stuck here rubbing these fenders with a rag and walking home in soggy old shoes. With them steadily depressing, low-down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. Of my ability, he should be smoking on a big cigar. But did I get myself straight? I guess I'll just have to wait in my rubber suit, rubbing these cars. But all I can do is to shake my head when you might not believe it is true. For working at this end on Niagara Falls is an undiscovered Howard Hughes. So baby, don't expect to see me with a double martini and in my highbrow society news. 'Cause I got them steadily depressing, low down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. Yeah, I got them steadily depressing, low down mind messing, working at the car wash blues.
I know it's kind of late, I hope I didn't wake you, but what I've got to say can't wait. I know you'd understand. Every time I tried to tell you, the words just came out wrong. So I have to say I love you in a song. I know it's kind of strange. Every time I'm near you, I just run out of things to say. I know you'd understand. Every
Every time I tried to tell you, the words just came out wrong. So I have to say I love you in a song. Something that I just gotta say. I know you'd understand. Every time I tried to tell you, the words just came out wrong. So I have to say I love you in a song.
This is another one of those character songs. I got out of a university in 1965, totally prepared for life in the 12th century. Kind of looked around here, looked around there, and then I got this brown letter in the mail one day, signed by a general. It said, come play with us. So I went down to a place called Fort Jackson in South Carolina, where they took my extensive college experience and put me into the infantry. As a lineman, I climbed telephone poles. It was communications. Yeah, stringing that wire from one place to another. And I met this guy down there who was in the company. His name was Leroy Brown. And Leroy was one of those guys that didn't know the meaning of no. You tell Leroy to do one thing, and Leroy would do another thing. He was just one of those kind of characters. He'd come from Chicago, been out in the street a long time, and had to make his own way. So he was about to keep on making it. He was down there a couple weeks, and he looked at me one night, we're sitting talking, he says, you know, Jim, I don't like this place, and I'm going to go home. So he got himself packed up, and he went home without telling anybody, except in the Army they call that AWOL, absent without leave. But he did come back at the end of the month to get his paycheck, and that was it. Snap put him in the handcuffs and took him away, but didn't bother him. He got out a little later, and still hung around. He was always the kind of guy that would keep people laughing. Unless he got in trouble with him. And this is a tune I wrote about him, just called Bad, Bad Leroy Brown.
Well, the south side of Chicago is the baddest part of town. And if you go down there, you better just beware of a man named Leroy Brown. Now, Leroy, what in trouble? Stand about 6'4". All the downtown ladies call him Treetop Lover. All the men just call him Sir. And he's bad, bad Leroy Brown. The baddest man in the whole damn town. Better than old King Kong. And meaner than a junkyard dog. Now Leroy, he a gambler. And he like his fancy clothes. And he like to wave him diamond rings upon everybody's nose. He got a custom Continental. He got an Eldorado too. He got a 32 gun in his pocket for fun. He got a razor in his shoe. Yeah, and he's bad, bad Leroy Brown. The baddest man in the whole damn town. Better than old King Kong. Meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, it was Friday, about a week ago. Leroy shooting dice. And at the edge of the bar sat a girl named Doris. And ooh, that girl looked nice. Well, he cast his eyes upon her. And her trouble soon began. And Leroy Brown had learned a lesson about a messing with the wife of a jealous man. And it's bad, bad Leroy
Roy Brown, the baddest man in the whole damn town, better than old King Kong, and meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, them two men took to fighting, and when they pulled them from the floor, Leroy looked like a jigsaw puzzle with a couple of pieces gone. And it's bad, bad Leroy Brown, the baddest man in the whole damn town, better than old King Kong, and meaner than a junkyard dog. Yes, it's bad, 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 bad Leroy Brown, the baddest man in the whole damn town, better than old King Kong, meaner than a junkyard dog. Yes, he was better than old King Kong, and meaner than a junkyard dog.
Were spinning round me, and all my thoughts were cloudy, and I had begun to doubt all the things that were me. Been in so many places, you know I've run so many races, and looked into the empty faces of the people of the night, but something is just not right. And I know that I gotta get out of here. I'm so alone. Don't you know that I gotta get out of here? 'Cause New York's not my home. Though all the streets are crowded, there's something strange about it. Lived about a year and I never once felt at home. I thought I'd make the big time. I learned a lot of lessons awful quick, and now I'm telling you they were not the nice kind. And it's been so long since I have felt fine, and it's the reason that I gotta get out of here. I'm so alone. Don't you know that I gotta get out of here? 'Cause New York's not my home. Couple of walls, but in looking back at the places I've been and the changes that I've left behind, I still look at myself to find I've learned the hard way every time. Yeah, I've had my share of good intentions and I've made my share of mistakes, and I've learned at times it's best to bend, 'cause if you don't, well, those are the breaks.
should have listened to all the things I was told, but I was young and too proud at the time. And now I look at myself to find I've learned the hard way every time. But in looking back at the lessons I've learned from the mountains I wanted to climb, I still look at myself to find I've learned the hard way every time. 'Cause I've had my share of broken dreams and more than a couple of falls, and in chasing what I thought were moonbeams, I have run into a couple of walls. But in looking back at the faces I've been, I would sure be the first one to say, when I look at myself today, I wouldn't have done it any other way.
To introduce my band over here on acoustic guitar and acoustic guitar, two different guitars, Maury Muehleisen. That's Maury. We lived down in the same area back in eastern Pennsylvania. That's where a lot of these songs had their origins. It's kind of funny because when I was growing up, in order to really have some kind of luck getting a girl to go out with you, you had to have a really souped, fancy, super duper kind of car with a lot of chrome on it. I remember there was always a kid in your high school that had two or three jobs to support this very heavy chrome habit. Used to have a car that, like, when you'd lift up the hood, it would look back at you, you know, one of those J.C. Whitney specials where everything came out of the catalog. But in the neighborhood where I lived, you know, some kids would send for the parts from the J.C. Whitney catalog, and then there were others who would go to the Midnight Auto Supply. I think every big city had one of those kind of things. There was a friend of mine named Nicky who used to walk around with a screwdriver in his back pocket and a little socket wrench. And all you'd have to do is go through the catalog and pick out the part and say, Nicky, there's one of these parts down on 2nd Street, and come back with the chrome mirror and everything. That was a whole different time, though. Like now, it's gotten into stock cars and sports cars and everything. So where we're living is like pickup truck country. We see the guys with the rifle racks in the back windows. And on Sunday, when they aren't out cutting their lawns with the lawnmowers with the rifle racks in the back, they're out at the stock car races. And we go up to the stock car races in Reading, Pennsylvania, every Sunday when we're home, and watch the guys sitting up on the bank drinking an RC Cola and eating a Powerhouse candy bar. So just imagine, like, we're in Reading, Pennsylvania, which is, by the way, the pretzel capital of the world. And we're going into a time warp. It's Sunday afternoon, no matter where we are, and we're going to watch the stock car races.
Whoa, Rapid Roy, that stock car boy, he too much to believe. You know he always got an extra pack of cigarettes rolled up in his T-shirt sleeve. He got a tattoo on his arm, I say, baby. He got another one that just say, hey. But every Sunday afternoon, he is a dirt track demon in his 57 Chevrolet. And he's a Rapid Roy, that stock car boy. He the best driver in the land. You know he say that he learned to race a stock car by running shine out of Alabama. Oh, the demolition derby and the figure eight is easy money in the bank. Compared to running from the man into Oklahoma City with a 500-gallon tank. And he's a Rapid Roy, that stock car boy. He too much to believe. You know he always got an extra pack of cigarettes rolled up in his T-shirt sleeve. He got a tattoo on his arm that say, baby. He got another one that just say, hey. But every Sunday afternoon he is a dirt track demon in his 57 Chevrolet. Dig it.
boy so cool, that recent fool. He don't know what fear's about. He do 130 mile an hour, smiling at the camera with a toothpick in his mouth. He gotta go back home, name of Dixie Dawn, but he got honeys all along the way. And you oughta hear him screaming for the dirt track demon in his 57 Chevrolet. And he's a rapid roy, that stock car boy, he too much to believe. You know he always got an extra pack of cigarettes rolled up in his t-shirt sleeve. He got a tattoo on his arm, I say, baby, he got another one that just say, hey. But every Sunday afternoon he is a day track demon in his 57 Chevrolet.
Once we were lovers, but somehow things have changed. Now we're just lonely people trying to forget each other's names. Now we're just lonely people trying to forget each other's names. What came between us? Maybe we were just too young to know. Now and then I feel the same. And sometimes at night I think I hear you calling my name. These dreams, they keep me going these days. Once we were lovers, but that was long ago. We lived together then, and now we do not even say hello. We lived together then, and now we do not even say hello. What came between us? Maybe we were just too young to know. Now and then I feel the same. And sometimes at night I think I hear you calling my name. These dreams, they keep me going these days. Between us, maybe we were just too young to know. But now and then I feel the same. And sometimes at night I think I hear you calling my name. These dreams, they keep me going these days.
If I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever,
if words could make wishes come true. I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know that you're the one I want to go through time with. If I had a box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true, the box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. Looked around enough to know that you're the one I want to go through